got a numbers file. I want to paste the data into Affinity Publisher, into a table. So how do I do that? Well, let's just quickly delete this and then just quickly create a table. And I'm just going to go over here to the table, and you'll find that in the tools panel, and just quickly create it. Now I'm going to create one. It doesn't matter the number of rows and columns, etc. I'm just going to go now to my numbers. And I'm just going to select some entries here. I've got a load of books here. I do lots of book reviews, etc. You may see that other channel. And I can now just go to edit and copy. So I'm just going to copy all that data, all the various annuals, etc. Now, what I can then do is go back to Publisher, and I'm going to go here to this cell, and I'm just going to paste. So just paste it, and of course, the data all gets put in a single cell, which you may want, you may not want. But what you can also do is you can select all of it. So I'm just going to quickly select all of that. Now, I don't know how many rows I've selected or columns, doesn't particularly matter. I'm just selecting it all. And then what I'm going to do, I'm now going to go to edit and paste. So edit and paste, and it's just put in. And you've got all the data now. Now, of course, you see I've got a couple of rows that I don't want. So I can just go down there. I can get rid of them. So I'm just going to quickly go there. And you'd think right click. Well, there's no one option there, unfortunately. But table and go to delete rows. So delete rows. And you can remove them. Now the table is slightly off the page. I don't want that. I want it to be obviously on the page. And when I resize it, I can resize it there. But you notice what happens. It just will put it down. But at least it's done that. It's just put it on the page, which is a key thing. Of course, what I can then do is I can tidy it up a bit more. So I just go over here and I just go to this top row because the top row has been imported completely empty. I don't want that. Now you could put some text there, of course, you could put like the name of the magazine or book and the author, etc. Well, I can also delete the row. So delete the row. Also, I can select all of them. Don't have to select them all. I could select one or two maybe. But you can go up to the top here, top left, and go for one of the fonts. Now you can go for impact, whatever. Just run through there, change it to that. You can also go and change regular to bold, and also change the size. So I'm just going to make it a bit smaller so it all fits nicely on there. Now also what I can do, I can just go over here and you can see there's a little, so I can resize the column. Now if I've got them all selected, they all will resize. Now I don't particularly want that, but it's a good way of resizing the column like that if you want. Now also I can just go down there and I can resize the whole lot there as well. So you can just do the whole load of, I think it's quite good to do that. Now, I don't want that. I just want to resize this column. So I just go there and you hover there and you can just drag that out. And it will reach a certain point where it says, no, what? I'm not dragging it anymore, which is fine because I'm just going to resize that one and so on and so on. So you can just resize them. And of course, page count, look at that and think, well, you know what? Now, sometimes there is an option here. Auto fit column to contents. I must admit, that's fine. It does work. However, sometimes it's not what I want. So sometimes when it generates, I prefer just to do this. It's just me, but that's the way I quickly do it. Of course, if you've got 5,000 columns, you might not want to do that, but I like just to manually do this and just change and tweak. And of course, just resize. Now it's probably best to go the other direction to actually do that. Again, up to you. Also, what you can do, you can go to, say, like an individual one here. So I just resize that one and say maybe because I want that to be more pronounced. But also, I can recolor things. So I can select this whole column. With this column, just go to the table panel and you can find that in View menu, Studio and Table. And you can go over here. You've got a fill option. So fill, and I'm going to say, I'm going to have that as red. Now, that's a bit too dark. Don't want it, you can't, you see the text. Now, I could change, obviously, the text color. Perfectly reasonable, but I can also go over here to the opacity. There's opacity there, so you can just reduce it down a bit so it doesn't look so bad and you can read it, obviously. And you can do the same with this one, so maybe go to this one and set that to blue and so on. If you want to have a slightly more colourful design again, change the opacity there as well. But also what you can do, you can go to the board. So I've got that one selected. Now I could select multiple ones, of course. In fact, why not? Select multiple ones. And I can go down here to border. And I can click on there and then click on there and so on and so on. So you can change the border in numerous ways. I'm just going to select that one for now. And then I can resize that and click there. And you can just say, you know what, I don't want the width there. I want it to be, say, like that. Now, the Luckily, it doesn't change the color as well. It just changes what you're working on. So I've got here the width, and you can also modify the pressure, etc. Maybe you have dashes. If you go for this option, you can put dashes around it if that's what you want. Now, obviously, I don't want it like that. That's a bit extreme, but maybe you just have it slightly there and you can see the result of that. Just makes it stand out a bit more if that's what you want. Now, of course, you can do many, many other things to this as well. You can resize it again, rotate it, add layer effects to it, and much, much more. You can also, if you've got Affinity Photo, maybe add some effects to it as well. So you can apply all kinds of, and I'll be doing a tutorial about that. I'm going to import some data. So I'm just going to go to File and Place. So that's another way to do it. Obviously, I've just pasted it in. But this time, I'm going to go to File and Place. Now, I haven't got a table displayed. So I'm just going to go File and Place. And now, got here, Comic Collection 1, Library Book. Click there, and then you get the design all imported. Now, of course, the results maybe are not exactly what you want. You can still, obviously, it's a lot of processing to move all those tables. But you can individually, again, in exactly the same way, go and modify each of the columns, modify all the rows. So you can go up here and you can see you can tweak it, change the font size, the colours, etc. in exactly the same way. So that's an Excel spreadsheet. Now, it doesn't seem to work with numbers for some weird reason. So you can't place a numbers file. But of course, you can, if you're on a Mac, you can place it by just copy and pasting, which is just probably just as easy. But it's a way of doing it. You can place them in by that command, File and Place, and then just bring them in. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.